and welcome to another Friday Focus video. Today I'm going to be making a card using this adorable stamp set from Kelly Perky. This is the Newman stamp set. I mean, it's all about cats, so how can I resist? I had to get the stamp set and try out a card with it. So I'm starting out with some Nina Desert Storm Environmental cardstock, and I'm scoring it at 5.5. It's going to be a side folding card. Just scoring that and getting a nice crease. All right, and I'm gonna do a bunch of stamping on this. I'm gonna use the large cat paw, and I'm just putting it on a small block. I'm using Stampin' Up! Crumb Cake ink. It's a nice craft color. And I'm just gonna do a bunch of paws. The center's gonna be funny. I think I'll have to put it on my stamp press. I'm just stamping a bunch of paws to make a background. I'm going to have something that's kind of up here near the top, so I might not stamp all the way up to the top, but all of this around here, I want to for sure get all of those paws. In fact, I'm revising my plan. I was going to have it cover the entire surface of the card front, but now I'm kind of liking the idea that it's in one corner, so I'm going to have it kind of come around right in this area. I think that would make it really interesting. All right, now I'm going to be using this stamp set from Mama Elephant. This is Basic Borders, and I'm planning to use the sentiment on the cat stamp set that says, "You're the cat's pajamas." So I thought it'd be kind of fun to stamp some stripes that sort of look like pajamas. So I'm using my ruler just to get this on here straight, and then I'll pick up the block, or pick up the stamp with my block. I'm going to use Hero Art Soft Pool Shadow Ink, and I'm going to make these, I'm going to stamp this at a diagonal, and I only need a small portion of this white piece of cardstock, but I thought I'd stamp it and then I can use it on another card. All right, now I have this piece of Basil candy bar cardstock, and it is cut to 4.25 wide by 2 inches tall. And I'm going to be stamping and embossing the cat and then also the sentiment that says, "You're the cat's pajamas." And because I don't want my embossing powder to stick to areas where I don't want it to, I'm going to apply a bunch of powder to make sure it's not going to stick. In fact, before I forgot to do this, I'm going to need to adhere it to this diagonal piece of paper. All right, so I've adhered that down. I'm going to trim it down so it's just right there. All right, now I can do my stamping. So I'm going to put my embossing powder right there, or my embossing magic powder bag. Starting out with the cat stamp, and I'm just coating the stamp with some Versamark. And I'm going to have the cat sort of look like it's sitting. It's going to be right there. All right. And then I have the sentiment, "You're the cat's pajamas." And I'll get that with Versamark ink as well. I'm just using a scrap of paper as a drop cloth for this gold embossing powder. So that tail's gonna peek down below. All right, there's a little tiny gap in between where the tail comes down. So I'm gonna use my Versa marker and the brush point and add a little bit of Versamark ink right in that gap. And now I'm going to add some embossing powder on top. I'll clean up any of the area with a brush. And then I'll hit that with my heat tool again. Okay, I have these buttons from My Favorite Things. These are the Berrylicious buttons. And I thought it'd be kind of fun to use these since we're making it look like pajamas. All right, I'll wait till I've got the rest of the card assembled to put that on. I'm gonna put this on some foam adhesive. It's a little warped from all the embossing, so using some foam is gonna help kind of flatten it out. And then a white gel pen with dashed lines around the upper portion. if you have any areas that are kind of drooping and looking off, you can take your foam squares and just cut a little tiny square and then use scissors to lift up the edge, slide that foam underneath, and then press it down again, and it'll hold that area up. All right, I'm going to figure out where I want these buttons placed. I think maybe about like that would work. Gloxy Accents is a really strong adhesive. You just have to let it dry. All right, and last but not least, I'm just going to round this top corner with my half inch corner rounder. All right, and there's the card for today. This style of card kind of reminds me of some of the cards that I made. Oh my word, this button keeps moving. That button does not want to stick down. This style of cards reminds me of some of the cards I made kind of a while back where I had a large panel. I'm going to try some Tombow Mono Multi-Glue there instead. Where I had a large panel in the center of a card and the background was really simple. Kind of reminds me of that. So it's kind of fun to do something so familiar, you know? So there's this week's card and I hope you guys enjoyed. I have three videos for you guys to check out as usual. The first one is my most recent Color Wednesday. The one in the middle is last Monday's Make a Card Monday. And the very last one is last week's Friday Focus video where I showed you how to make two different cards using the same die cut. And I asked you which one you liked. Looking through the comments, it looks like it's just about even. A lot of people who didn't like texture loved the first one, and those who kind of loved texture liked the second one. So it's really a kind of a toss-up up in the air. If you haven't seen that video, go and check it out and let me know in the comments which card you liked best. If you like this video and want to see more videos like this, more card making videos, be sure to hit the subscribe button in the top corner. And you can always find me at my blog at kwernerdesign.com. You can follow me at Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest as well. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys on Monday for a new Make a Card Monday video.